Hi everyone, and welcome to this review note. In this clip, we're going to be setting up a standard access control list to filter traffic going through a router on Cisco IOS. I've got two different networks over on the left with clients, one plant, one staff, and on this side, I've got a server. What we're going to do is configure a filter so that staff can get to this data and plant cannot. We can see the network for plant, and let's try right now and make sure we can ping over onto the server. Once ARP gets resolved, we can see the ping is successful. We'll go over and do the same thing on PC2. Can see here that the network is different, 122 in the third octet instead of 121. And our ping is now successful. Over on our router, Ethernet 0 is connected to the network that the server is on. This is plant up at the top, and this is staff at the bottom. This is the one that we're going to want to filter. The way we're going to do that is create an access list outbound on this interface. We're going to allow the plant traffic and not allow or deny the traffic from, or sorry, the staff traffic will allow and then the plant traffic will deny. First thing we'll do is configure that access list. Two commands for that. First command creates an access list, standard, name is block plant. Second command is actually the access control entry. I'm going to permit anything that has these values in the first three octets. We know that because in the wildcard, those three octets have a value of 0. Anytime there's a value of 0 in the wildcard, that means there has to be a match. The last octet, we have 255 in the wildcard. I'm not going to worry about that. That can be anything, meaning that anything that's on the subnet is going to be permitted. Because access control lists have an implicit deny, anything other then this permit is going to be allowed through. Anything other than the permit is going to be denied. I can show my access lists. Here is the access list with the single access control entry. The other thing we need to do is actually apply the access list, and that's going to be outbound on gigabit zero. Command for that. We specify IP access group, not access list. We can specify the name. And then we specify either inbound or outbound. Let's try that out. Over on the plant PC, I try to ping the server. We can see that we get a message back saying that the host is unreachable, which it was not before. The message is coming from the router. So it's the router that's telling me, hey, you can't do that. Try on staff, I can still successfully ping the server. We're blocking all traffic from everything in the plant, so there's no traffic whatsoever allowed to go through onto the server. Whereas over on staff, we allow all traffic, so there's no filtering there at all. That's setting up standard access control lists. Hopefully this has been helpful for you, and we'll see you next time.